battery.
No, because...
Entering Levi's Stadium for the first time for the inaugural game. It is Seattle Sounders and San Jose Earthquakes.
Dignity Health, Gate C, and Toyota, Gate F. Nissan scores 1 hour after the completion of the event.
Thank you.
They were going to have a feeding of the fish. We actually do that twice a day. My name is Joe. I'm one of about 1,600 volunteers here. And this is JoJo, so it's real easy, Joe and JoJo. Today our diver is Maureen. Maureen works and lives in San Francisco. And twice a month she gets in her car and drives down here, puts on a dry suit, feeds the fish, then goes back to work. That's a 2-hour drive each way. So we're real nice to Maureen. We want to keep her coming. She's been doing this for almost 30 years, I believe.
Hey, Joe, how are you doing?
Great, Maureen, how are you?
Excellent.
1, 2, 3.
Hi, Maureen. Awesome. I have Joe and JoJo.
And you have the lady sheephead hanging on your shoulder.
You know what? I'll tell you, she's actually a little scarier than the male sometimes.
These humpback whales are. They're about 45 to 50 feet long. And they weigh anywhere from 25 to 40 tons. So they're really big animals. And you can see even with their tail, we saw a bit of the head there come up out of the water. 3 o'clock. So you can just see the size of their head compared to those sea lions. The sea lions aren't exactly small. But compared to the humpback whales, they look minuscule. So we have several humpback whales in the area here. Now, it's not often the case that we see a lot of the humpback whales together. A lot of the time we will only see them in pairs of 2 or maybe 3 individuals, but sometimes they will come together for cooperative feeding. Now, they're not your typical social mammal like the orcas or the dolphins. That are very different. You won't find them in big pods of closely related individuals like those animals. These animals are much more solitary and they form very loose and very temporary social bonds. And they're mostly for the purposes of feeding. So that's why we see a lot of times the whales are scattered around in the bay. This is really cool because we're seeing a lot of them in one close area. Awesome looks right there, these two whales. So that looks like it could have been a mom and a calf pair. You can also see differences in the dorsal fin. Some of them will be more pointed like that whale's. And then some of them will be a little lumpier or more... Oh, lots of whales popping up here. Whale soup! Awesome. awesome look. You can see the pectoral fins under the water. This whale at 10 o'clock, you can see the green glow of it just below the surface. That whale's not too far under the water, so just about to come up. Awesome look. You guys are getting a really cool show. So this pair here is mom and calf here on our left at 9 o'clock. Calf's kind of rolling around a little bit. On its side, you see its pectoral fin just come up out of the water right at the surface. And there's mom, a lot bigger than that whale to the right. Super close at these whales. From its dorsal fin along the side. So a lot of times these whales have scars. Look how big these animals are! Amazing! You can almost see it down their bowl!
We should make sure you're hanging on here. I can't put it in gear right now, so I gotta let it go. We're gonna be in the trough here, so.